Today I'm going to share with you my very simple and easy laundry routine that I do as a family of six with four kids. Well, hey everybody, welcome back to my channel. I'm Sarah of MyMerryMessyLife.com and author of the book Detox Your Home, which you can find on Amazon, and it includes more than 80 DIY recipes to help you go non-toxic and natural in your cleaning, laundry, bath, body, and beauty products, and also in your food. So today, I'm gonna show you my laundry routine. Welcome to my laundry room, by the way. Here's my dryer, my washer's down here. We've got my lovely organization system back there that I'm gonna show you more in detail in a minute that my husband built for me. Yeah, so I just wanted to share with you how I do laundry, because I know this is one of those chores that as moms can be one of the most absolute dreaded things, the thing we hate to do. Now, of course, there are exceptions. My grandmother and my mom both love to do laundry, and they always have. I don't know about you, but I did not inherit that gene. I have always hated laundry. So I've had to find a way to make it work for me and make it more pleasant for me. So before a couple of years ago, I had no routine whatsoever. I just washed whenever a hamper would get full. Often that meant that my hamper was exploding, and it was like a mountain of laundry. It was when my kids had no underwear or no socks. And it was very haphazard. It was all over the place. It was very stressful. You know, I would start a load of laundry and just leave it in there, and it would turn into mildew and it would get nasty. I would have to wash it again. Then I'd put it in the dryer and then forget about it. And it would sit in the dryer for a day, and then all the clothes would be wrinkled and I'd have to dry them again. Not good for the environment, not good for our water bill, not good for our electricity bill. It was just not working in any way, shape, or form, and I absolutely hated the chore of folding the clothes. It took me a little while to realize, oh, I have an actual laundry room with a door that shuts. So what I do now to make the folding part more enjoyable is I have my phone out on the counter back here, and I play my favorite YouTubers or a favorite TV show, but usually it's YouTube, because those are like 12 to 15 minute videos, and that's all it takes for me to fold. It's usually only 10 to 15 minutes. And that also helped my mindset to realize, hey, I'm only taking 10 minutes to fold all of this. It's really not that much time I'm spending. It's not a big deal. So like I said, before a couple of years ago, my laundry routine was totally haphazard, stressful. There was no organization to it whatsoever. I'm not a naturally organized person, so I guess that makes sense. So then I finally figured out, okay, I hate this so much. Maybe if I only wash on Saturdays and Sundays, that would be better. And then I can take a rest Monday through Friday and not have to worry about it during the week. Well, that worked okay until our two oldest boys started doing sports. Your whole Saturday is taken up by sports, and we enjoy doing those things. And we were enjoying family time and going and doing things, you know, going out to eat afterwards or eating lunch after their games. I didn't want to come home and do chores and do laundry when it's like a family day. And Sundays, I really like to take Sundays to rest, because if I don't take that Sunday to rest, I can barely make it through the week. So I was just like, okay, this isn't working either, you know, and that system just went out the window, and I couldn't do it anymore. What would also happen is the laundry would pile up so much that I had a massive amount of laundry to do on Saturdays and Sundays, including sheets and towels. It really was not working. It was literally a full 2-day job. And I did not want to spend my entire weekend that I'm supposed to be having fun and resting and relaxing with my family in the laundry room. So then finally, in the fall of 2020, I came across the Flylady method from Diane in Denmark, my friend Diane in Denmark. She's another blogger and YouTuber. My mind was blown away, because it makes so much sense. And you've seen probably some of my Flylady videos. If you haven't, I'll link to them up here. And it has been an awesome system of cleaning, decluttering, and organization for me, and has really helped me get my life on track. Like I said, I'm not a naturally organized person. So if you're like me, you might really like this system, because it's based in routines, not schedules, but routines. And I do very well with routines. I don't do well with schedules, but I do well with routines. I've been following her laundry routine, which is part of my daily routine, which I'll link to that video up there, my daily routines. And my part of my daily routine is doing one load of laundry in the morning. I get dressed every day, drink my coffee, eat my breakfast, and unless I'm intermittent fasting and then I don't eat breakfast, I do a load of laundry. And I have disciplined myself that when that load of laundry goes in, I make sure that it gets folded soon after it's done. And I don't start the load of laundry if I'm not going to be home within the next couple of hours to be able to fold it. But I really did have to discipline myself to make sure I folded the clothes that came out of the dryer, and also that I would take them from the washer to the dryer. So that took a little bit of like, okay, Sarah, get yourself in gear here. You've got to get this done. So what I love about the Flylady system is I'm only making myself do one load of laundry a day. So I feel accomplished if I've done just one load. Now in my family, one load doesn't cut it. One load a day does not cut it with six people. We have to do 2 to 4 loads on some days. Now some days I can just do one load and we're fine, but the laundry never piles up when I do just one load a day. So it has been working really well for me. Things are not sitting in the washer and getting moldy. Obviously there's exceptions because life happens and some days get super busy. You know, the laundry doesn't get finished. I don't sweat it. I know I'm gonna start over again tomorrow and or the next day and it's gonna be okay. But having that as part of my daily routine is now, it's so automatic. Wake up, get dressed, make my coffee, start a load of laundry. Like, it's so automatic, it's easy. I don't have to think about it. And then of course, like I told you, when I'm folding, I'm watching my favorite YouTube videos. I oftentimes will shut the door. Sometimes I hide some chocolate here in the laundry room. And so I eat a little bit of chocolate and watch a YouTube video. And I'm like, dude, this is nice. Like, it's actually enjoyable to do my laundry. Another part of the Flylady system is the weekly home blessing hour, which I'll link to that video up there above too. But it's taking 1 hour in your week to clean the high traffic areas of your home. As part of that hour every week, I change the sheets and wash the sheets on our bed, me and my husband's bed. And that day is Thursday. That's the day that I have set for me to do my weekly home power cleaning hour. So Thursday is the day that I wash our sheets, which is definitely gonna be an extra load on top of the clothes that are coming in. The kids' sheets, you know, they don't sweat, they're young. I don't have teenagers yet, so they don't get their sheets very dirty. They always take their baths at night before they go to bed, so they get into the bed with clean clothes and a clean body. So their sheets, I don't need to change but every 2 weeks or so. That I don't have like a strong system for. Mostly what I'm doing is when I'm putting their hampers back into their rooms, I take their sheets off if I know it's been about 2 weeks. Now I probably could, you know, put a reminder in my phone or something to make it more systematic, but for now it's not stressing me out. It's not causing me any problems. So it's been okay. You know, it hasn't made my life more difficult. But if you want more of a system, you might want to add that into your, you know, routine, one of your daily routines. Maybe every Tuesday is changing one kid's sheets day. As far as the bathroom towels go, I do change those out once a week. So when I change out me and my husband's sheets on Thursdays, I also bring the bath towels from our bathroom and wash those. So Thursdays is definitely a 3-load day, but sheets and towels are pretty easy to wash. I mean, they take a longer time in the washer because I do a long cycle, you know, with hot water to make sure they get nice and clean. But I don't have to worry about if they sit in the dryer until the next day, right? I don't need them to be not wrinkled, at least as far as the towels go. Now for the sheets, what I've been doing is taking off the sheets on the bed and washing them and then putting those same sheets back on the bed. And that way I don't have to fold any sheets. So that makes life a little bit easier. So that's a little tip for you. You could also do that with the kids' sheets if you want to do that. Who likes to fold fitted sheets? Anyone? Anyone? Yeah. Didn't think so. If you do, let me know, because I would love to know what your trick is. So as far as organizing my kids' laundry goes, first of all, I like to keep their clothes down to a minimum. I like them to only have 7 to 10 outfits, which may sound like a lot, I don't know, but for me, that's enough. And then I only have to wash their clothes once a week. So they each have hampers in their rooms. When their hampers get filled up, they bring their hamper to me. Now, their rooms are upstairs, the laundry room is on the main floor. So for my younger kids, that hasn't been possible. The hamper's too big for them to carry. So for my two younger ones, I often bring their hampers down for them and wash their clothes for them. My littlest, she's 4. She's sort of kind of getting to the point where she can put her clothes away, but I still like to put them away. Maybe I should start making her do it, but I still like to put them away so they don't get all wrinkled. So I've been doing that. So for my 3 boys who are 11, 9, and 7, when their hamper gets full, they bring their hamper to me and I wash it that same day. It's only one load. Each hamper is only one load. So that works out really well. I fold it, I put all the clean clothes back into their hamper, and I either take their hamper to the room, because like I said, a lot of times they're heavy, or the boys come and get their hamper, I put it at the bottom of the stairs, put it back in the room, and put their clothes away. And I often don't let them do their daily video time or game time or TV time until they've put their clothes away. That's how I make sure that chore gets done. And they're always motivated to do whatever they can to be able to watch TV or play video games. So it's very easy to get them to do that chore. So that pretty much covers it for my kids' rooms and my kids' laundry. So now I'm going to show you my laundry room. I'm going to show you some of the natural, non-toxic products that I use here and how my basket system works over here. All right, so here's my laundry room. So I've got my washer down there, my dryer up there. We used to have the washer here and the dryer here. Then I bought a new washer and a new dryer, and they were too big and we couldn't close the door. So we had to stack them. So now it's kind of nice, and I'm just gonna show you my real life over here. But I hang my coat and my purse right here because the garage is right there. Got my drying rack right there, my broom, my vacuum right there. So I've got everything I need, and the kitchen is right outside of here. So works out really well. All right, so here is my countertop that my husband built, and I know I painted it bright red. I like bright colors. So there's my laundry soap, dryer sheets, clothes that need to be dried or clothes that need to be hung up. I have extra towels and things up there, stored up there, like if the kids are out playing outside and get really wet and dirty. I have scrappy towels up there they can use to dry off with. I also have our beach towels and swimming towels up there. So this countertop my husband built for me, and here's where I fold our clothes. And lately I have actually been keeping it this clean. So here are my four laundry baskets. So over here I keep the whites, over here I keep the darks, over here is the delicates, down there are wash rags and towels and things like that. And then I keep bed sheets and over flow down in that basket down there. There's a bottle of vinegar down there. That's what I use as laundry softener. And then I store my household cleaning supplies right here. I've got these nice little baskets where I organize the cleaning supplies. Okay, so last I wanted to show you my non-toxic laundry products that I make myself and use in the laundry room. Making these products myself saves me a lot of money because I buy the ingredients in bulk, and so that works out really well. So here is my natural laundry detergent, and I'll link to the recipe video up here in the card above. And I'll also have a link in the video description below. But yeah, this is my laundry detergent. It uses Dr. Bronner's Sal Suds, salt, and water. That is it. It's just three ingredients. And it has a natural pine scent with a pine essential oil. So it smells really good. It's good for HE washers and standard washers. I really like it, and it works great. The second thing I use are these dryer sheets. I pull them out of the top here, and I have a whole video on this as well that I'll link up there and in the video description below. But you pull out these little sheets and you throw them in the dryer. It may sound weird, but they have vinegar in them. Vinegar, water, and essential oils, that's it. These are like baby wipes that I rolled up and put into this lovely glass container. These are my labels you can download from my Etsy shop. They're printable labels you could use over and over again. So these soften the clothes and they add fragrance, which is so nice when you're using natural laundry products. One of the things that can be a drawback is that there's no more fragrance, and our clothes sometimes get smelly year after year after year. So that fragrance is nice. So I like to add a lot of essential oils to this. I do lavender, peppermint, pine, lemon, things like that. Yeah, so I really have found that these reduce the static in the dryer and soften my clothes and make them smell a lot nicer. Got the recipe on the back, the label on the front. So the last thing I use in my laundry is just a bottle of vinegar. You could add essential oils to this to add even more fragrance if you want, but I put this in the fabric softener compartment of my washing machine, and it really helps with keeping the clothes soft, and it also adds some cleaning power as well. So I've always liked using vinegar in my laundry routine. And when your clothes come out of the washer and dryer, even when you use the dryer sheets, there's no vinegar smell left at all. There is a strong vinegar smell when you put it in, but I promise you there's no vinegar smell afterwards. The heat really dissipates that smell and you don't smell it anymore. So those are my natural laundry products. I only use three things, very easy, very simple. If you would like a powdered laundry booster and softener, check out my video up here. I do use that, and I have liked that for many years. It uses Epsom salts and super washing soda, so it does boost the power of your laundry detergent and softens your clothes. So you could check that out if you'd rather have a powdered version and you like hate the smell of vinegar or something. Use that instead of the vinegar. So I said there was only three products. I really meant four. I forgot about my stain remover, and I have a video for that as well that you can find up there or in the video description below. You know the drill. So this has kosher salt, Dr. Bronner's Sal Suds, water, and lemon essential oil. And all of these things help to remove stains from clothes. I have found this to work just as well as OxyClean, which used to be my go-to forever, but I don't like the fragrance in OxyClean. It does work very well, but the fragrance really bothers me. So I like to use my homemade version one better, and you need to leave it on for 15 minutes, just like any other stain remover. It's always best to wash the clothes out, to rinse the clothes out right after they get a stain, and then spray your stain remover on it and then wash it later on. And I have left this on for days at a time. It doesn't discolor or damage the fabrics or anything like that. And two more quick tips I wanted to give that I do, and maybe they will help you, is I wash all of our clothes on cold water setting, unless my kids have, you know, had an accident in their clothes. Those clothes I'll typically wash with warm water to get those a little cleaner, and it'll be a smaller cycle. But in general, I wash all of our clothes in cold water, and that helps keep them lasting longer. The colors don't bleed, and I can also combine lights and darks. So that makes doing the laundry way easier. I just wash all of the clothes from one hamper. And this also helps me to keep the kids' clothes separate. And when it comes to folding, I know I'm only folding Gabriel's clothes, or I'm only folding Grayson's clothes. And so it makes it much easier than having to sort through everyone's laundry, because with four kids, it's just a lot. I found before that if I was trying to sort all of their clothes at the same time, it was a lot of extra work. That I do much better washing each kid's hamper by itself, and then I'm not having to figure out which size is whom. You know, before I was having to like look inside each, you know, shirt and go, okay, is this a size 7 or size 9 or size 8 or size 6 or whatever, and then having to, it was a lot of work. It added more time than it needed to. So I wash all the clothes on cold water. Now sheets and towels that get real gross, I will wash those in hot water, and I also have a steam setting that sanitizes, and I do that setting as well. So that's it, guys. Thank you for watching this video. I hope it helped you with your laundry system. If you've got some tips that could help me, let me know in the comments below. I'd love to hear from you. What laundry system do you use for your family? What are your favorite natural laundry products? Let me know in the comments below. And if you liked this video, please make sure to give it a big thumbs up. If you haven't subscribed already, make sure you do that as well. And that's it. See you guys next time. Bye.